Hi, I'm Dr. Ellie Summers, the owner of Sisu Sports Performance and PT in Seattle, Washington. And today I wanted to talk to you all about something known as the female athlete triad. Being a physical therapist, performance coach that works with a lot of female athletes, I feel like this is an important part to touch on, particularly when we're talking about youth. And I was reading this article. Let's see. There you go. Recently, and just wanted to kind of summarize some of what the female athlete triad is so that folks can start to take note of these signs and symptoms and maybe help these athletes get better. So there are three characteristics in the female athlete triad, and in order to like qualify as having the female athlete triad, you really only need one, or even just have signs and symptoms of one of these. So the first one is low energy availability. And this is equal to energy intake, so what we consume in energy, minus the energy we use, which includes not just that we use during exercise, but that which is also used during normal daily activities and by our normal body functions. This first characteristic of low energy availability can occur with or without eating disorder. So if we've got an athlete with some low energy signs and symptoms, it might be something that we need to take note of. The second one, the second characteristic of the female athlete triad is menstrual dysfunction. And this occurs along a spectrum, from normal menstruation to completely absent. This one in particular can be a challenging piece of the triad to assess with younger female athletes for a number of reasons, but a large reason is because there is some irregularity in menstruation when you're young. With that, however, what I found from this article was that 90% of females will have a normalization of their menstruation within 2 years after starting it. So if you've got an athlete or a child, or you have a situation where your menstruation hasn't normalized after 2 years of starting it, or you're having absent menstruation, it may be a sign that the female athlete triad is something that could be possible. The third characteristic of the female athlete triad is low bone mineral density. And this also occurs along a spectrum ranging from optimal bone health to osteoporotic. And bone mineral density can be diagnosed really only via a DEXA scan. But a sign of low bone mineral density might be something like recurrent stress fractures or recurrent stress reactions. So these three things are what make up the female athlete triad. Knowing about it is an important first step to being able to take action on it, because unfortunately in the system right now, it's hard for someone to pick up on these signs and symptoms without directly asking about them. So early detection is critical to an athlete's long-term health. And so that's why it's so important with youth that we're like aware of this. Some signs and symptoms include rapid weight loss, restrictive eating behavior or eating, fasting, use of diet pills, the cessation of menstruation or an abnormal menstruation after 2 years of starting, stress fractures or stress reactions, and overuse injuries that are slow to heal. So those are just some things to watch out for if you're a clinician, if you're a parent, if you're an athlete, a female athlete. The female athlete triad can be pretty serious, and catching it young and teaching young athletes how to manage their load properly and how to manage their energy intake and expenditure properly is a vital piece to the puzzle. So there you have it, just a brief synopsis, well, sort of brief, 5 minutes long, of the female athlete triad. I hope it helps you stay healthy and have a great day. Thanks a lot.